the end to the beginning. If we review the Torah, we find that there's an obligation for every Jew to respect every human being, even non-Jews. Everything derogatory or negative that was said about the Gentiles from the time the Torah was given until now, 3,322 years, from then to now, especially in the time of Chazal, our sages, about 2,000 years ago, were only to the idol worshippers and to the murderers, Gentiles. Those anti-Semites, such as the Nazis, some of the Arabs, that all they care about is to destroy the Jewish nation. The Torah told us, someone who comes is on the way to kill you, you have the right to kill him first. Or those who worship all kinds of idols, worship the stars, worship the moon, etc. Those are the negative Gentiles. But if they're not, which means they have basically two conditions. If they're not idol worshippers, they believe there is God, they may not be religious in any religion, but they believe there is God, they don't follow any statues, any idols, any stars, the moon, the sun, etc. And they are not active in any harm to the Jewish nation. They're not Hamas, Hezbollah. If they're not in this category, from that moment on, you have to treat them like an image of God. Every person was created in the image of God, Betzelem Elohim. You have to respect them. There's no permission to cheat them, to steal from them, to disrespect them. No permission to deceive them in any way. And as a matter of fact, the most important Kabbalist that we had in the last 2,000 years, his name is Rabbi Yitzchak Luri Ashkenazi. Everybody knows him as the Ari HaKadosh. Without him, we wouldn't know almost anything about Kabbalah. And I know it's in fashion today, Kabbalah, everywhere you go, you hear about it. But without him, nobody would even know what it is. Maybe few individuals. And everything we know from him came from his student, Rabbi Chaim Vital, that everything he wrote, we know. Whatever he did not write, we don't know. Everything we know, the Ari himself was not writing anything. So Rabbi Chaim Vital write clearly, that is an obligation to love every goy. Not only Jews. Jews, it's needless to say, the Torah referred, your brother, Re'echa. So we know that the Torah referred to Jews. What's new about here, that he writes clearly, it's mitzvah even to love the goyim. And again, I'm not talking the negative ones that I mentioned before, the ordinary, regular ones. The Gentiles have a share to the world to come. Many Jews, unfortunately, lost their share to the world to come. For instance, if they don't keep Shabbat, they have no chance to have share to the world to come. They lost it. And there's a list of sins that the Gemara brings. When does a Jew lose his share that he was born with, but he lose it, to the world to come? And believe it or not, there are many Gentiles, some of them have nothing to do with Jews, nothing. They hardly know what Jews are. They live in the other side of the world, but they keep the seven law. Those are the Gentiles who has a share to the world to come.